Hello, everybody out there in the bookverse. It's Stephanie, and today I am back with what I'm kind of hoping is going to be a new series on my channel, and that is going to be a series of me talking about my top five favorites of something, and then my top five least favorites or five flops of something. So five faves and five flops. And this is going to be a lot of different bookish related things. And this first one that I'm going to do is going to be my five favorite tropes. So if you're new to my channel, hey, welcome. Thank you so much for watching my videos. If you'd like to see more from me, definitely hit the subscribe button down below and the bell icon so you'll be notified when I post new content. But let's jump in to these tropes. I love when tropes are executed really well in books. Any trope I feel like I can dislike in book if it isn't done well, but these are five that I just tend to enjoy for the most part in most books that they're in. So the first trope I'm going to talk about is one that I feel like I pretty much always enjoy. I can't really name a book that I don't enjoy this trope in, and that's the wise mentor trope. Like, you know, Obi-Wan Kenobi and that type of thing. I'm a sucker for it. I love this trope so much. One book series that I really enjoyed in is the Aragon series. It changes throughout the series. I don't want to give any spoilers away, but Brom in the first book is just amazing. I absolutely love him so much. He is one of my favorite wise mentors. He's just taking Aragon along on this journey, and while they're going through this journey, he's teaching them all about magic and dragons and everything he needs to know to become this amazing dragon rider. So Brom is just, he has enough sass, but he's tough and he's very good to Aragon, and he's just so wise and seems to know everything. He just has that aura of being this all-knowing guy. So I absolutely love him. That is one trope that I will pretty much enjoy in any book. So if you know any books that have that one, list them down below for me, because I'm definitely gonna have to check them out. The next trope is the friends to lovers trope. Now, I know most people's favorite is enemies to lovers, but I actually tend to enjoy friends to lovers more than enemies to lovers. I like having that basis of friendship and then just seeing it turn into a little bit more. I love it. It's my favorite, and I feel like that's when I'm the most invested in the relationship, it seems like. A series that I think does it really well, but I know it's a series that a lot of people don't really like, and that's the Selection series. So towards the beginning, they are just friends. They decide she's gonna be friends with him. They're just going to enjoy their time through it, and she's going to be his friend in it, help him out, tell him about the other girls, right? That's kind of their arrangement. And then obviously it turns into more. I feel like this is not spoilers, because going into it, you know that that's gonna happen. Like, it's so obvious. This is not a series where you're not gonna predict things that come up. But I thought that it was executed so well in that series. I love this friends to lovers trope. And again, if you know any other books with this, let me know, because I feel like it's so much easier to find books with the enemies to lovers trope. But I love having that friend foundation, and I feel like they tend to be so much nicer and sweeter, and I love the nice, sweet guys. The next trope that I absolutely adore so much is the found family trope. And I know this is extremely common, especially in fantasy books. I feel like I see it a lot in these fantasy books, these found family aspects going on. But I just adore how it is done in Nevermore. I love the found family at the Deucalion, how you have Jupiter and Fenestra, and you have Morgan, and she has no family, and she just gets accepted into their cute little loving family, and they all have their quirks, and there's so many people involved in that found family, and I love how much they look out for each other and love each other. And that's something that I love in books. I love seeing them bond together and find these people that they are choosing to love and that they are choosing to put before everything else. And that's something that I think, if is executed executed well is amazing in books. It makes me get so much more invested in the characters. And so anytime we have the found family trope in a book, I think I enjoy it quite a bit more. I like having that element of choice in it. I think it adds a little bit something extra where you are choosing these people that you're going to love. You find people that match with you and that you just want to be around. So I absolutely love that. I mean, there's so many books that do this well. The Raven Boys, I hear Six of Crows does it amazing, like Mistborn, it's everywhere. And apparently it's everywhere because it works and people love it. And I'm one of those people. Okay, the next trope on this list is one that I know a lot of people, it kind of annoys them a little bit, but that is the here comes the cavalry trope. And I don't know why, but when I'm in these really intense battle scenes or these intense points and you don't think you're gonna win, you think you're gonna lose, and then someone comes to your rescue, you're saved, the hero's here, I just love it so much. It's so good and it just makes me so happy when I read that. A book series that does this so well and kind of frequently actually is the Lord of the Rings series. If you've read it, you know. If you watch the movies, you know. It's a thing. They tend to love this, oh no, we're not going to be able to survive this. And then your reinforcements come, the heroes are here, you're saved, we win, it's amazing. Like the sun comes out, literally. So I absolutely love that trope. I think it's great, and I don't even mind it when it's just one big hero that comes or a couple heroes that come and save the day and turn the tides. I love it. It gets me so excited. I cheer them on so much, and it's just a trope that I'm a sucker for. And the final trope on this list is a trope that also not everybody loves, and that is the chosen one trope. I don't know why, but I just like it. I love when you have that chosen one who is meant to save the world and they have what it takes in order to turn everything around and to defeat either the dark forces or the dark lord or whoever needs to be defeated to save the world. I love it. I love it most when they're not extremely reluctant and we're not having to like push them along through it the entire time and they're not whining about it. Because that really bugs me. But I love it when they kind of, like, they can fight it a little bit, they can not think they're adequate, but then they accept it and they do what they gotta do. And one series that does this pretty well that I really enjoyed is the Wheel of Time series. Now, I'm not completely all the way through this series. I think I'm only through book 4 at this point, so really not that far into it, but I'm really enjoying it so far. This is very classic chosen one. This is the one that was born to be this person who saves the world. It's not just a you come in to the role. No, you're born into it. And I know that that can be kind of hard sometimes to execute well or to actually enjoy it because it's hard to see this one person have so much power or so much responsibility and everything works out for them. But I like that. I like having our one really tough warrior who's supposed to save the day, and it's fun for me. I don't particularly love Rand in the Wheel of Time series. He kind of bugs me a little bit quite frequently, but the way that it's done I think is very interesting. The whole reincarnation, the dragon reborn aspect of it is something that I really, really enjoy. So those are 5 tropes that I tend to like in books. They're ones that I think are fun and I will enjoy series a lot when they have those in it, or books. It doesn't have to be series. So let me know some tropes that you really love and that you think you pretty much like in all the books. Let me know down in the comments what you think. And as always, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button down below and the bell icon, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.